Happy Friday. I'm really looking forward to this weekend. Of course, it's Mother's Day, and it's an opportunity, a time for all of us to reflect on our mothers. Our mothers, all our mothers, were our teachers, and they come in different packages, different sizes, different personalities, and they taught us in different ways. I want to share with you a remembrance of what Abraham Lincoln has to say about his mother. He says, "I remember my mother's prayers. They have always followed me. They have clung to me all my life." What a beautiful remembrance of his mom. Yet this Sunday, we're going to take a different view of motherhood. We're going to look at the divine mother, the feminine face of God, Lady Wisdom, the divine feminine. In each of us, we have our masculine traits and our feminine traits. Last Sunday, we talked about the masculine face of God, that power, the creator that created all the world, of which we were all a part from the very beginning. But what we know is that to be balanced, we need to have activated within us both our divine masculine and our divine feminine. And right now, our world is calling for each and every one of us to expand the divine feminine in our own lives. How do we do that? It's about having an inner look, an inner vision, touching that reality, that truth, that love, that wisdom that's in all of us. And when we do that, we can feel the interconnectedness, our oneness with all life, and not only improve our own lives, but truly make this world a more loving, cooperative place to live. So join us this Sunday. We have a very special ritual for honoring the divine feminine for all the women in our congregation. It will be a wonderful Sunday for us to connect, to remember, to love, and to share. I hope to see you there. Please remember, I love you all. God bless you.